So this video is from my channel. This is some soggy cereal. I love soggy cereal, and I love mixing my cereal. This is a mixture of Special K and Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Special K is probably my top three, definitely my top three favorite cereals. Then Captain Crunch and Life. Life is probably number one. Life cereal is number one. Special K is number two. Captain Crunch is number three. Actually, Captain Crunch, I think, will be number two. Special K 3. Rice Krispies 4. I think that's the order. Definitely Life. Life is amazing. Like, there's no words for it. Number one is Life for sure. I dream about Life cereal. That's how good it is. I go through withdrawal over Life cereal. Life cereal 1, 2 Captain Crunch, just the sweetness of it, texture, amazing. Captain Crunch, then Special K. Special K, when it gets soggy and, you know, right amount of sugar, it's everything. And same thing with Rice Krispies. Cinnamon Toast Crunch I like a lot as well. In all of these, I eat a soggy. Life cereal, got to put a little bit of milk in there. I don't like a lot of milk. Put a little bit of milk. Let it sit there and get soggy. Give it 10 minutes sometimes, even more. Just do some other things while the cereal sits in the bowl and just get soggy. That's good enough for Life. Captain Crunch. Life, I add a little bit of sugar. Don't need a lot. A little bit of sugar. Captain Crunch, don't need any sugar at all. Special K, I put a good amount of sugar. And it has to be right amount. Actually, even if it's a little less, it's still good. If it's a little too much, yeah, it's a little bit too much, I'll just add some milk to it. Maybe even some little bit of water. And then Rice Krispies, you gotta have a good amount. And you need to have the right amount of sugar for Rice Krispies. A little bit too much sugar, and it just too sweet. It just ruins the taste, ruins the experience. Under a little bit too little, and it just is a little bland. You definitely want to have it right. I have an art to it. I don't have any sort of measurement with how many teaspoons or how many seconds to pour the cereal, whatever the case is. I just kind of have a instinct with pouring it onto the Rice Krispies, and for the most part, I get it right. So I've kind of been interested too in how cereal gets soggy, and I think I'm gonna put some in another bowl and let it and watch it, you know, take a video and see how it gets soggy. Another thing, water and cornflakes. A little bit of water, no milk, a little bit of water and cornflakes is good too. It gives it this slight honey taste to it. Growing up, I had that as a kid. If we didn't have milk, we just used water. And surprisingly, I remember the first time I had it, I think my mom suggested it, and it was delicious. Yes, it was really good. I was surprised. So water and cornflakes. I don't think I've tried anything else. Frosted Flakes too. Frosted Flakes is good. Hot cereal. I love cereal. As you can probably see, I love cereal. I eat cereal breakfast, lunch, dinner. I eat it for dinner often. But hot cereal, specifically hot cornflakes and hot Frosted Flakes. I haven't really had anything else hot. Put it in the microwave. A good amount of milk. Put it in the microwave, 2 minutes, a minute and a half. Nice warm heat, warm slash hot temperature. Not really warm, not really hot, but warm hot, warm slash hot. And it's great. There's a little bit of crispness to it, and it has some sogginess to it as well. Sometimes I'll put it in the microwave and then I'll add a little bit of fresh cereal to it, add some more crispness to it, and then add a little bit more milk, because obviously with the heat, the cereal soaked up, you know, quite a bit of the milk. So and I put some fresh cereal in there, so I want to get that moist with milk too. So I do that hot cereal. What else? Your water, hot cereal. But yeah, I think I'm gonna put some more in this bowl. And, ate half this bowl already. I was about half full actually. I ate most of it. Yeah, sometimes I just want to keep eating it because it looks good, tastes good. But I'm full. But I do want to have a little bit more, possibly a few more bites. But I do want to see how the soggy cereal, how cereal gets soggy. So I'm gonna put some in a bowl with some milk. And just watch it, see how see this transformation of crisp, dry cereal, slightly moist cereal becomes this delicious bowl of sogginess. Kind of want to see that transition. And this is actually my computer setup. Flask. I work from home. I got two screens. Two screens set up. Third. Two monitors set up. Third laptop. This is my other laptop here. Close that. Some laptop around here too, as you can see. So it's a pretty decent setup. My room. In the corner of my room. This water bottle's getting empty. This right here, this water bottle. Lifesaver. Lifesaver. It's about 40 ounces. It is 40 ounces. Called Iron Flask. I thought it was on here somewhere. Yeah. Forty ounces. Should be able to see if it's in view. Coming up backwards. Yeah, I don't know why it's coming up backwards. But, yeah, 40 ounces. Why won't it get into better view? It's a little blurry. Anyway. When it's cold, I can put cold water in this in the morning. By the evening, it's still cold. I don't put any hot in it. I don't drink anything hot, really, except tea, but I don't put tea in it. I have a little teacup for that. I'll show that. I'll get that little teacup. but I love this thing. I take it everywhere with me. I always have it. I'm always putting water in it. It's always water in here. That's it. Cereal bowl, hang tight.
Cereal crumbs, all that little powder, cereal powder. I finished the cereal, so some of the powder, I guess, fell out. Condiments, a little juice, not much, some pizza. Yeah, some adobo, cream cheese. I love bagels. I gotta buy some bagels actually. Cookie dough, bake some cookies, pizza down there. Freezer, waffles, salmon. This is ramen. This is awesome from Costco. Delicious. A little bit.
some light in there. Maybe that's too much light. I think it's good enough.
So we'll watch it and see.